40 years it's been. 40 years. Oh, hello all. Simpsons Clips 24 here. You've just caught me philosophising about another Gerry Anderson project that didn't get off the ground. In this case, it was a film. Let me tell you all about it. So, in 1977, immediately after filming on the second series of Space 1999 was completed, Gerry Anderson and music producer Sidney Rose began fundraising for a feature film project, which the two of them would executive produce, while Tony Barwick worked on the script, which he titled Five Star Five. I suppose the best way to describe Five Star Five is that it would have been both the British Star Wars and the Magnificent Seven in space. It focuses on John Lovell, no relation, an ex-soldier turned space freighter captain, recruited to help protect the planet Kestra, which is about to be destroyed by an attacking Zargonian invasion force. He scours the galaxy in his B-156 transporter and ends up finding four more recruits, including a talking chimp and two robots, one of which is a demolition robot that just wants to be loved. I have a copy of the script somewhere, and believe me, there was a lot more that would have looked amazing on the big screen, including vast starships, a supposedly impregnable asteroid fortress, a plethora of action sequences, and even a rather funky floating restaurant. It would have been one of the most visually spectacular films from the 70s sci-fi boom. In 1978, pre-production began on Five Star Five, with John Guiyaming attached to direct. He also did the 1976 version of King Kong, and David Lane as the associate producer. He had directed the Thunderbirds episode Attack of the Alligators, and had worked on Space 1999 as its supervising editor. The main production designers were to be Michael Stringer and Keith Wilson, the latter had also worked on Space 1999, and storyboards had been drawn up by comic artist Kevin O'Neill, whilst Alan Hume was assigned as the lighting cameraman. He would later work on Return of the Jedi and Space Precinct in the same profession. Brian Johnson was also attached as its special effects director, just like he was on Space 1999, and regular Anderson model maker Martin Bauer had created some spaceship designs. It looked like everything had been set to go, as the studios had been booked, with special effects filming due to start at Bray Studios on 22nd October 1979, and live-action filming at Pinewood Studios on the 19th of November 1979. Model maker John Sorensen, who would later work on the first Alien movie, had even built this small model spaceship, and a gun was even made. So how come everything didn't go according to plan, I hear you ask? Well, unfortunately, as is the case with most of Gerry's unmade productions, financial issues got in the way. In this case, a few weeks before production was due to start, the project abruptly lost funding and was abandoned. To add insult to the injury, none of the major ships had even been built before the film was scrapped. However, every cloud has a silver lining. Whilst most of Gerry's pre-Terrahawks library is owned by ITV, the team at Anderson Entertainment own the rights to Five Star Five. And who knows? Maybe one day we'll all get to see it. And you're more than welcome to post your thoughts about it in the comments below. See you later. Bye!